Hello guys, what's up? Your host Overlord Tico here. How are my friends doing today? Bringing you guys some Digimon World 3. Alright, so I was having some problems. I don't know if I told any of you guys, but I was having some problems with my PlayStation 1 and with my PlayStation 3. And for some reason, it wouldn't load up some games, including this game. So I don't know. I know I told a few of you guys before to somebody. Like, it wasn't loading it up right, but today it's loading it up, so I'm gonna start playing. But if it does freeze, then that's why I gotta keep saving, you know, so that way any process that I do make, it actually stays. Because, I mean, I'm already playing upstairs in my brother's PS3, but I wanted to play in this PS3 with a different pack of Digimons. So Overlord Tico is ready to bring you guys some Digimon World 3. And what do you call it? Yeah. As you guys can see, you see those little blue blocks, the loading blocks in this Digimon World 3? Well, those loading blocks wouldn't go away. After this first part in the game, they wouldn't go away. They would just stay in the screen and wouldn't load up anymore. But I did a little trial run for like 20 minutes, and it worked. So here I am, and let's get ready to rumble. Alright, so we don't have time to play Digimon online. Anyways, we won't have time. Anyway, so this is Junior, the main character of the game. And he is me, pretty much. He is the trainer. So, we're gonna kick some ass with him. He's waiting for his friend. Their friend. AOA. Whatever they're called, I don't remember. Anyways, he's waiting for, what do you call it? He's waiting for his friends. Ivy and Teddy or something like that. They're called something. And it was that AOA team that you guys heard the news about or whatever. It's a bad group that does bad things to Digimon. It's international crime group or something. So yeah, I don't know. If any of you people haven't played this game, that you guys should get it. I was fortunate enough to get a copy of this game for $10 at one of my local game stores. And I was pretty happy about that because, what do you call it? I was pretty happy about that because online, if you try and buy it on eBay or on Amazon or something, you might find it like, what do you call it? You might find it like 50, 60 bucks. I don't know. And this, for some reason, the PlayStation Store doesn't have it. So, yeah, that's bad. Anyway, so we finally decided to go to the Digimon place. All right, so this is where my game usually freezes. And I guess it's not freezing now, so that's not a problem. He's loading up perfectly. Alright, so let's get ready to rumble, guys. Like I already said, Overlord Tico is ready to take on Digimon and beat it all over again. It's been a few years since last I played this game, so we're gonna have a great time. At least I am. Alright, so I'm gonna skip through all this talking, pretty much. So they're admiring the beauty of the place and what do you call it? Now they're gonna decide which Digimons they're gonna keep. Oh my god, this is crazy. Alright, so first time playing Digimon online. You know what's funny? This is my favorite game out of all the Digimon games. Like, what do you call it? The Digimon World 1, Digimon World 2, and Digimon World 3. I didn't like Digimon World 4 at all. I thought it was kind of bad. So this guy's undecided. He doesn't know which Digimon to pick. Like, what do you call it? Each pack, there's three packs you can start with, and each pack has like a different Digimon, something like that. So yeah, pretty much he's trying to decide which pack he's gonna keep. But he's like, I love all Digimon. He's a nerd. But he is me, so it doesn't matter. Alright guys, let's see if we can get ahead with this guy a little bit. I mean, like, I don't got a sore throat. I've been just like a little cough. I haven't been coughing today. It's just like, I've been like coughy, like like that. But not like big coughs. Just like very small coughs every now and then. Might be getting sick, which is not good. I doubt it. Oh well, I never get sick. I'm a beast. All right, register account. We gotta first register my name. All right, let's put Lord Tico. There we go. Now we can click OK. And all right, we got Kumamon, Gilamon, and Patamon in this pack. Then Monmon, Agumon, and Renamon in this pack. And then we got Kodamon, Renamon, and Patamon. I prefer the All Angel pack. Angelic creatures or whatever. Because they kind of look angelic, all of them, whenever they reach their mega form. So I'll pick this one and register account. And yeah, it's a balanced pack. The other ones are kind of whack to me. They don't got healing stuff, and this one does. It's funny because these guys were telling him that he needed to hurry up, and now he just left him because he was the first one who registered, because they were waiting on him for him to pick which Digimon he wanted, and now he just like goes away by himself. It's funny. I can start playing the game. This is exciting. Oh my god. I am so awesome. Not really, I'm not awesome. Alright, so let's see here. I don't know if you guys can hear my clicking. Hopefully you can't. I love it. They like put their hands like, I'm gonna punch this guy in the face. Let's fight. Let's get down on the ground, sirs. Alright, so it's time to head into the digital world. Let's kick some ass. I wonder how big each part I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna try to make each part at most like 2 hours. I'm not sure, you know. I don't want to make each part too long because some people can't keep up for some reason. Some people are kind of slow. They just can't keep up. They can't comprehend the magnitude of the video. It's like this is too much. I just can't do it. Can't handle it. All right. Welcome to Digimon World. I remember the first Digimon game where the Digimons they actually got sick and everything. They had to go poop. You had to feed them. You had to have them bathe or whatever. I don't know. They had to poop. It was something weird. Those Digimons were whack. I didn't like them. But in Digimon World 2, it was like different. I don't know. Digimon World 2 was each stage was like a maze or something. So yeah, I'm just skipping all this talking because all this is like tutorial stuff. They're trying to tell you important stuff, which doesn't matter after the first 5 minutes in the game. All right, let me switch this real quick to my analog. I can use my analog stick. All right, so we're just gonna talk to her. I wish she could give us our Digimons finally. I am doing my planking position. This position is good. It helps you stretch your back, which I do need big time. Now these two guys finally get here. Lord Tico, what's up? Teddy. Now her name is Kale. That's what her name is. He's like, that's a dude name. And he kept his name as Teddy because he was too lazy to change it. Awesome. Kodamon, Renamon, and Patamon. Three awesome Digimons. Hi everyone, I'm Lord Tico. Nice to meet you. I'm going to fight my best, thank you. Let's all aim to become world champ. I won't disappoint you. I'm counting on you. Let's go. Let's do it. Let's kick some ass. Alright, so I'm gonna try my best to, you know, become the awesomest person in this game. Become number one in the world before the world ends and save it from destruction. Alright, we are in Azúcar City. I mean Sugar City in Spanish. If you spell it with a C and then you put an R at the end. Are you new here? Blah blah. This old timer. Tamer Genji. Alright, so he's gonna fight me because he wants to test how strong I am, so let's kick his ass. Alright, let's do I believe insects are weak against fire, and this guy's got a fire attack, so. Attacks. No! Don't do it! can't beat me down. All right, let's hit him real quick. I love the way all the Digimons, whenever you beat them in this game, they try to get up. I like that. I like it that they try to get up whenever you beat them. It's like, can do it. You're pretty good. You have potential to become the world champ. Some little pep talk here and there. Now he tells me to go to the Digimon lab. There's really nothing important you want to learn in the Digimon lab, but let's go there anyways and talk to one of those women and see what they say. See what they say about Kodamon, because I want to make my Kodamon as strong as possible. My Kodamon, I'm in my Paidamon. Alright, let's see. Yes, I love to hear information. I will only display data under satellite. Kodamon can learn Agumon and Vmon types if you train machine tolerance. So that means if Kodamon levels up to whatever level, let's say champion level, then we train machine tolerance, he'll gain additional evolutions from Agumon and Vmon, pretty much Greymon, Metal Greymon, War Greymon, he'll get XVmon, Pale Dramon, Imperial Dramon. That's why Kodamon is the best one for me, because he switches to all of them, you know. Once he learns ultimate training, strength, machine, and wind tolerance. We don't care about that. We care about Renamon's spirit or his strength and defense. Wisdom and strength. They don't have anything important else. For Agumon, you gotta train his darkness. If you train his darkness, he'll get his Skull Greymon form, and then he'll also get... You see that loading right there? He'll get his Skull Greymon, then when you level up Skull Greymon, he'll gain Blackboard Greymon. So he becomes really good too. Alright, let's go down here. Get a box real quick. It's a quick box, we gotta get it somewhere. It's funny because I remember a lot about this game. Alright, let's go to the sewers. Let's get this box. 300 bit. You need money in this game, trust me. You're gonna need money if you wanna kill some enemies quickly. Alright, let's go get some cards at the yellow place. They got some good cards there. Can't wait to kick some ass against each one of the leaders in each city or something. Hey, talk. It's like he's running into the wall. Through the counter, I mean. Divermon. I love those Divermon dudes. Divermons are the guys you gotta talk to, so they give you cards. Now these guys are trying to talk about how to play the game. But don't worry, I'm gonna play a game later on, and then I'll show you guys how it's played. So you guys can see how good I am at this Digimon card battle. Apparently I play a lot of card games. Too many. It's like, they're one of my favorite hobbies. Card games, board games. Help me relax. Get smarter. Become better at math and guessing and probability. I don't know. Yeah. Alright, thanks. But who am I gonna talk to? Blah 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 blah. Thanks for everything, Diamond. Good luck. See ya. Alright, let's get out of here. Alright, so there's really nowhere else we can go now, so we can just set out the city. Let's see real quick. I'm gonna go ahead and save the game. Like I said, just in case anything does happen. And the person we gotta talk to save the game is the Gardramon or something. Let me see, he's right here. Anyways, we talked to the Catamon. We gotta talk to her if we wanna heal ourselves. She's like the inn owner or whatever. And then Guardamon or whatever. He's the one that saves our files for us. Prepare to save, son. Alright, I gotta fix this real quick. I gotta assign a slot. PSX 1, a slot 1. Alright, now we're safe. It's got I got three internal PS1 memory cards. There are not enough blocks. 4 blocks I needed to save. Alright. So I gotta assign slot 2 here. PSX 2 to slot 1. Apparently that one is full. I think that one's the... Alright, create new data. Yeah. Apparently, I think that's the one I use for like all my games. For like Yu-Gi-Oh, Forbidden Memories, Yet Cocoon, all those games, you know? So that one is full. PS1 memory cards don't got a lot of space. They fill up pretty quickly. PS2 actually made a big improvement. You know, those 8 to 10 standard megabytes that they had lasted for at least like a while. Like 4 times as many games as you could handle on one PlayStation 1 memory card easily. Although there are some games that take a lot of space. What was it like? Grand Theft Auto or something takes a lot of space. I don't know. Games, massive games like that, games where they got massive cities or massive environments or something, they usually take a lot of space. All right, let's get out of here. Let's see. I keep knocking into everything. Jesus, is there a box down here? Alright, no, there's nothing down there. I couldn't remember. Alright, so let's go out and fight some demons. We don't want to go too far though. We wanna stay kind of close. Damn. Sorry about that. Sickness. Alright. And this game is random fighting, so... we just want to stay around this area real quick, because these are the weakest Digimons in the game up here. Oh my god, some fight up here already. This is weird, why am I getting no fights? There we go, oh my god, it's like... sometimes you want... that's a weird thing. Sometimes you don't want to fight and fights appear, and other times you don't want to fight and fights don't appear. So let's do a hot head on this guy. Oh, I forgot my health still hasn't recovered from the other guy. Should be able to do some decent damage. Yep, one hit kill. Alright, let's see how much experience we get from this. Apparently not enough. Central Park. Alright, let's talk to her again. Sorry, I'm not interested in younger boys. What are you talking about? I'm not interested in old girls. Actually, I am interested in older women. Is that a bad thing? No, it's not a bad thing. But they have to be sexy. Of course. I'm not a pushover. A sexy older woman. Alright, a power charge is what we can use to heal ourselves. It's like, it heals like 500 health or something like that. Something awkward, blah 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 blah. Weird. Let's do a hot head and finish off this guy. Alright, let me see real quick. I gotta get my remote. Level 2! Alright, there we go. Alright, let's get down to the stairs. Alrighty. We don't wanna go left. Left? We don't wanna go to the left because our left side is bad, actually. Our left side is a little bit too strong. We gotta be at least level 5 to go on the left side. In my opinion, because in the left side, your people die really easily. If you go over there, your demons are gonna get annihilated big time. That is a guarantee from me to you. Hopefully, my Katamon, whatever. He gets strong quick. I want him to level up. But one thing is, I mean, you like, as soon as this Digimon gets tired or whatever, you want to switch to the other Digimon. You want to battle in this game. You want to battle as much as possible, big time, for sure. It's important. Oh, also, each time you level up, you get 5 training points. TP, I believe it's called. Stand for TP, training points. And you can go talk to that lion right there, where the training place is at. And you talk to him, and you train with those 5 points, and your attack, defense, whatever you want, gets stronger. So that's like a very important part of the game. Very important aspect of the game. Alright, so as you guys can see, I think I'm out of mana points, magic points, or whatever to do a special attack. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go here, go to status, real quick. I wanna check something out on the Digimon and show you guys something. Alright, we got nothing yet. No Digimon. We got no equipment yet. We got the 5 TP on the right there. You guys can see on the bottom left corner. Alright, let's go to sort real quick. Since my mana points already ran out and I can't do that attack anymore, I'm going to switch Patamon to the first one. And now Patamon is going to be the first one that appears. The first top Digimon, he's always going to be the first one you start with in the battle. So I did that just because I don't want to risk that Digimon dying or anything, you know? Alright, let's see if we have some more battles up here real quick. Alright, another thing is, I'll show you guys. Look at my Patamon, he looks so awesome. I love his ears. He's like Dumbo. Boom bubble. Boom bubble. I don't think wind is very good against. Oh, I guess all these Digimons are kind of weak. Hey, did 550 damage. That's pretty good. Some Digimons take longer to level up than other Digimons, so you guys gotta keep that in mind. Alright, let's keep moving around. This is far too big for a mole. Those holes and these little square things in the water are going to become important later in the game. He's telling you that. Important for one factor, travel. You can travel underground through the water. We first gotta get a little bit further in the game, of course. We can't do that yet. It's gonna save us a lot of walking time, because walking around and running into battles makes the game last a lot longer. So you guys can tell this guy levels up easier. He needs less experience to level up. Kodamon needed like 3 battles, and this guy only needed 2 from that weak Digimon. North, as you can see, East, Surgery City. Yeah, we're gonna go to Surgery City later. And I'm like level 5 or 6 with all my Digimons. Or another thing is, once we get our Digimons to level, what do you call it, champion level? Whenever they get to level 5, they get their first Digivolution. They get their champion form. So their champion form is pretty important, because then we can go back into the city. We want to go back into the city as soon as we get their champion form. Back into Asuka City, because we got to do something. That's important to getting stronger early in the game. Let's see if this guy falsely want to hit. Oh, son, you're defeated. Overlord Tico took you down 2 notches. Ugh. I think I need some orange juice. I should drink some orange juice. Ugh, Jesus. Blah, 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 blah. This is annoying, having to move around this much. We still don't want to go on that side either, because that side is a little bit stronger as well. We'll go there later, don't worry. It's not over yet. Once we get our Digimons to level 5, 6, or whatever, we'll be able to move around a little bit more freely, so this is just temporary, guys. So just hold out for with me. Hold on with me, you know. Just hold out. Do something. Just stay with me for now. Because this is not going to last forever. So now it will be like the first hour of the game. So, I mean, if you want to skip like this first hour of me playing, you can. And you're not going to, well, you might miss a few important steps in getting stronger in the beginning of the game. Or like things you could do, or places you could go early on or whatever. But not many people probably don't know how to play this game because, you know, it's an old school game. This is one of those old forgotten gems that nobody ever hears about anymore. I mean, there's a lot of people, a lot of like older people that play it still, but for the most part, the new generation don't know anything about this. I call them newbies. New generation, I would say 15 and below. Now, if anybody 15 and below is watching this video, don't get offended. I'm just saying, you guys never hear of games like this, and you guys never really did play them. I think, like, the new generation started around the PS2 era, like, you know, when the PS2 was starting to become good, and then the Xbox was like about to come out. Anybody who's like 15 or less about now, it started around the PS2 era, coming into the Xbox era. Ah, I'm out of experience and everything. Alright, my mana points ran out, guys. That's not good. See, that's why I didn't want it to run out. Alright, I'm gonna have to hit this guy big time. Oh man, this guy actually hits harder than me. Plus, my health is kind of low right now. Spadamon, it doesn't have a lot of health. I still gotta do 3 more hits to be able to kill him. I got another idea, though. I got a big idea. Oh man, he was attacking twice. What a punk. I'm gonna beat his butt to the ground. Oh, my Patamon is tired. Look at his face. Alright, I'm switching my Coatamon real quick. See, my Coatamon actually does a little bit more damage to this guy. I like his stance. Like, puts his hand on his side, on his hip. And I hold his sword up in the air. Alright, let's see here. I don't know if I want to do this. Yeah, let's do one attack. Yes! Awesome. Coatamon, you are the man. But now they both gain a little bit of experience, so that's good. Oh, for some reason, Coatamon leveled up with less experience. That's weird. Huh. Maybe, I don't know. I guess maybe each one. I can't remember quite. I guess some of them. Depending on which level it is, depending on what level they're going to, they need more or less experience. That's weird. Because some of the later games, what do you call it? Some of the newer games usually have like standard experience for everything, you know? Everybody has a set standard point of experiences they need for every single level. And it's usually the same across the board for everybody, so you're gonna know when every person's gonna level up. At least it's like that for the games like Jade Cocoon. It's like that in Jade Cocoon. Oh my god, I am so tired. I'm tired of running around. Literally. Not me, I mean, my hands are tired of running around. My hands are not tired, but I'm tired. I bet you this guy is. I've ran him on, see what you got. What's up with this guy attacking so much? Awesome, awesome. Awesome, alright. Diamond Storm. Alright, hopefully. Yep. It seems each one of them can actually like kill somebody right off the bat with one of those attacks. So that's a good thing. Alright, I feel like going right, but I don't remember if on the right side people do get stronger or not. I'm not sure. I don't want to go. I'll wait a little bit longer. Alright, this guy should be a piece of cake. For sure, for my Diamond Storm. I guess I'm gonna keep playing this game along with other games. I'm gonna probably start a let's play of a few different games at the same time, including this. I'm already playing this game. I'm probably gonna play Chaos Legion, and then I'm also gonna play Star Ocean. I'm gonna do a let's play of all three, and then I don't know if there's any PlayStation 2 games, any other PlayStation 2 games that I want to do a let's play of. Digimon is a PlayStation 1. Chaos Legion is PlayStation 2. And Star Ocean is PlayStation 2. Chaos Legion and Star Ocean 3 are the only games that I still have left that I really want to do a let's play of and before my PS3 era goes out. Because as you guys know, I'm playing on my PS3. But what if my PS3 era decides to die and not play any PS3 games anymore? Because I wouldn't change it for another fat PS3. I would exchange it for a new... So one of those new, what do you call it, Slims with just the HDMI. Nah, not really. I would exchange it for a Slim with the HDMI component. Because I already got an HDMI cable, but most importantly, they both cost the same thing. So you're pretty much... What is it? You're pretty much giving up... I don't know. You're getting 40 more gigs, but you're giving up the composite input in the back. That's kind of weird. I don't know. It's a good trade. It's a good trade if everything you got in your house is, if you got a bunch of HDMI cables and everything in your house has HDMI compatible stuff. But if you don't, it's not good. I wouldn't do that. But you know, whatever. It's up to Sony. You know, Sony gives people more options. That's good. That's what Xbox. That's what 360 and. You know, and Microsoft, they give people more options. People kept saying, oh, the 360 is cheaper than the PS3. So for a long time, supposedly the 360 was better because it was almost the same, you know, cheaper. Not really, you know, when the PS3 cost like $500, it still had a lot more stuff than the 360 had. It's just the online, and the PS3 wasn't that good, and it didn't have that many excuses you can get. It seems like the developing company still hadn't gotten around to the idea that PS3 actually, you know, being good, because you know it was costing so much, and they wanted the price to go down first. That way, more people would actually get it and buy their product, buy their games on it. Because you know, these companies, they're selfish. You know, they're not gonna put games on a system if they don't, you know, people don't buy it. Not because the system's not good, not because it doesn't have a lot of features. Because the price is a little high, you know, but that's what happens with any new system. And if a brand new system is cheap, then you know there's something wrong with it. And for the most part, the new PS3s, the ones that started with had a lot of options. You have one with 20 gigs, 40 gigs, 60 gigs, 80 gigs. You could get them that they could play PS1 and PS3 games on it. You could get them that they could play every single game system. So you had a lot of options. It wasn't like you had no options. And I'm running back and forth here in the bridge because I want a battle to appear, but I don't want to be far away because I need to go back in the city and heal again. But yeah, it's just weird, you know. Yeah, the 360 cost like what, $300? People say, oh, it's much cheaper, but it was lacking so much stuff. It was lacking Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, 1080p HDMI. What do you call it? Wireless, everything. Yeah, the wireless for everything. I don't know. Another reason is, for example, the Red Ring of Death. What did it have? The 360 had like a 30-something percent failure rate or 40% failure rate within 2 years of owning one. That's not a very good record. It's not a very good record to keep, you know, with a game system. Plus, you had to pay like $60 to $100 for the wireless adapter for a 360. That's crazy. You know, when you thought about it, even just the trouble it cost you to get all the extra accessories you needed to make it be kind of close to what the PS3, everything the PS3 had, it almost cost exactly the same thing. It's just that people were lazy. People just don't like it. People just don't like spending money like that, you know. And I don't understand why, because I mean, you know, if you're playing the games, so the same games you got, you already got them on the system, why get the other one, right? And then when all the PS3 exclusives started coming out, people started, oh yeah, the PS3 is good, the PS3 is good. Oh yeah, I'm gonna get the PS3. I'm like, man, people are such losers. It's like, a couple months ago, they were all saying the PS3 sucked. And then they're saying the PS3 is good. The PS3 beats the 360. It's like, pick a side, you know? I always knew which system was better. Which was better system, more reliable, had the better games, the more exclusives. The one that was going to have the most exclusives and everything. Right off the bat, you know, the one that was actually worth my money. So, I don't know. I don't like people that, you know, one moment they're here and then they just go with the pack. They just go with whatever people say. They got no opinion. I despise people like that. It's like, get out of my face. Don't talk to me. You're not worthy to talk to me. That's what I would say. So, yeah. That is my opinion, guys, on that matter. So, some of you might get offended by it, but you'll live, I'm sure. It's not like you're going to die or anything. Oh no, he said the PS3 was better than the 360. Oh, what is he saying? Is he insane? No, I'm pretty right about what I said. I'm pretty sure. Even more now. I mean, I haven't really heard of any exclusive game. I mean, think about it. All the 360 exclusives that come out the late 2010 and this 2011 year, it's crazy, man. There's nothing good at all. There's no good exclusive for it. I think the only memorable exclusive that I remember for the 360 that was actually like an original game, not a sequel, was, what do you call it, Ninja Blade and Star Ocean The Last Hope or something like that. And for some reason, Star Ocean The Last Hope didn't come out for PS3 first. It was weird. It came out for PS3 later with like 7 languages and like, you know, you could change the menus and stuff. But I mean, it's just like, I don't get it. Why? It's just weird. Weird. So yeah, I don't know. These just people, man. They don't understand. They don't understand the way things work. Any new system is always going to be better. You always got to look at the facts, you know? I think the PS3 always had like a 10% failure rate, like getting a yellow light of death. So like 10% of all PS3s within 2 years get a yellow light of death. So, I mean, if you're in the lucky 10% within those 2 years, then there's nothing we can do for you. But at least you're not, you know, where the 360 people were back a couple years ago, where they had like 30 to 50% failure rate within 2 years, you know? Or they say, oh, we can just return them and, you know, it's near the warranty and Microsoft would just send us another one. But it doesn't work like that, man. Because I can't be doing, especially me. I had a 360, but I bought the 360 Elite. The one that's 120 gigs, the black one, and that one was very good. I heard that, from what I've read, that was the one that didn't get the red ring at all. Barely ever got it, so I bought that one, you know, it was worth the price. And the few months I did have it, had no problems whatsoever with it, so I don't know, I think that's the best one. The funny thing is, though, whenever the 360 Slim came out, within the first day that it came out, somebody posted up a video getting a red light of death, red dot of death, or whatever with it. Damn. Man. I think I need some water, guys. Yeah, but this is like red dot of death. Are you serious, man? Come on. You gotta be kidding me. Within the first day, somebody posted a video when they released it, getting a red light of death and like crunching up the disc inside it or whatever. Something like that. It was so freaking weird. I bet you Microsoft was pissed that somebody posted that video up. You never see anything like that with Sony. And then whenever the power outage came out, people was like, oh, Sony sucks, whatever, let's go back to 360. So all those people that I told you about, the ones that I don't like, that just go with the flow, you know, they just go with the pack, with whatever people say, got no opinion, people I despise a lot, go like, oh, Sony sucks, man, they can't defend their stuff. How many times has Microsoft been hacked, you know, like, what do you call it? How many times have the Xbox been hacked? Like, it's been a lot of times. And I don't know, man. People complain about Sony happening one time. I mean, it was a big deal, but I mean, they gave us a pretty good welcome back package, you know? They gave us a PlayStation Plus for one for 1 month. They gave us a few free games and everything. I think it was worth the wait, you know. I got to go trophy hunting a little bit. Even though I never tried to complete 100% any game, just play enough to where I can beat the story or whatever and play online. But what do you call it? It's just weird. I don't know. People just need to chill out, you know. Just stick with the system they know is best, you know. It's not just keep switching back and forth. Those despicable people keep doing that. Someday I'll get them all. I'll go in your house and put a pillow over your head while you're asleep. Because it's not right, man. It's not right. I'm just kidding, guys. I wouldn't do that. But seriously, don't do it. It's bad. You know, be smart for a change. You know, actually make a good decision. Make a decision yourself. Don't just do whatever people say. You know, it's just weird. It's like there's whenever there's like a new the new trend. It's like, oh, everybody's shaving their head bald now, so I'm gonna shave my head too. See how that works. Are you seriously? You're gonna shave your head because everybody's shaving their heads? Everybody's jumping into from like 1,000 feet high to a lake. I'm gonna do it too. I'll be cool. And you fall and break your head. hit a rock. You're done for. That's it. That's what she wrote. That's what he wrote. Everybody, man. It's crazy. Alright, so we're nearing a level 5 and I'm tired. I'm thinking about getting some water, man. I don't know. I don't want to leave you guys here. You guys might just go somewhere, you know. Leave your, what do you call it? Leave your seat. Go somewhere. Alright, so since we got a lot of mana points for this shit now that she leveled. So we got a few more battles before the mana points run out, so we can hit a few more people, get a few more levels. Not really, I want to gain one more level only. 68 experience. One more level and she gets her champion form. Awesome. Alrighty, so let's see here. Once I get, oh, I mean, so this will be the last time, because once she gets her champion, once her mana points run out, she'll have her champion form, so. But I'm gonna do something, I'm gonna switch a Kodamon, then I'm gonna switch a Patamon, do the same thing with them. And once all of them have their champion form, I'm going back inside the city. Do that little thing that I told you guys that I gotta do there whenever I get them all to level 5. And then that's when the real game will begin. I'm gonna start moving around more. Oh my god, my neck is killing me. Alright, much better. I hate planking and playing at the same time. It's like plank, but I put up my head so I can talk in a microphone. It's weird. No, don't go that way. No, it's mine, sir. Well, honestly, I find your fascination with your son's death rather disturbing. I know shit, dude. My son died. What the heck are you talking about? I find your fascination with your son's death rather disturbing. I find this morbid fascination with your son's death rather disturbing. Alright, you guys don't understand me, but I know what I'm talking about. If you guys go on Netflix, look up Rowan Atkinson. R-O-W-A-N Atkinson, A-T-K-I-N-S-O-N. Look up Rowan Atkinson. And when you find him, watch. Look for Mr. Bean and look for his live performance. It's super funny. You guys will love it. Gotta be on Netflix, of course. And if you don't have Netflix, then where the hell you been? Everybody has Netflix. It's everybody who has $8 a month. I mean, that's pretty cheap for everything you get on there. If I think for like $11 or $12, you can get unlimited movies or something. You can get like up to like 3-4 movies at a time sent to your house, and you can exchange them anytime you like. You send them in, and exchange them for another one anytime you like. That's very good. You can't beat a deal like that. And other things like Hulu, the Hulu Plus, man. I haven't gotten Hulu Plus yet because I don't know. I'm not sure I want it because I don't spend enough time watching shows. My brother does it. I don't spend enough time watching shows. So I just like watch movies. So I got Netflix. And I was thinking about getting the Voodoo movies or whatever, HD movie thing. Getting that. And I don't know. I need to check out. I need to look that up and see how much that costs. Run. Yes. Fit through, right through. I need to check that out, how much that costs. Man, where's the next battle? Alright, she's got like enough for like two more battles. Alright, but what do you call it? Yeah, I mean, I just watch movies, like single movies, like two movies a day or something like that. One or two movies every day. Different movies. And what do you call it? I've been thinking about that Voodoo thing, or I don't know. Not Voodoo, I don't know what it's called, man. It's VO something, whatever it's on the PlayStation. You watch that and you watch HD movies. I don't know, but whenever you watch them, I'm asking you guys this question because I don't know, I don't got it. Whenever you're watching, do you have the option to actually like switch the language, you know? It's like playing it off the DVD or something, you know? Playing it like a DVD copy, because for example, Netflix is like standard DVD copy. For sure, it's standard DVD copy. That's what it is. They say, sometimes the movies right next to your name say HD, but it's not HD. It's just like a standard DVD copy. It looks like DVD resolution. But anyways, what I was thinking was, what about? Come on, play. What about what do you call it? Like, since it's like a standard DVD copy, that's all I was thinking. It's just the quality. But on that HD movie thing that I can't remember the name of now. Do you actually have the option to like switch your languages? Because on Netflix, you can only put it in English. I mean, because for example, what if I want to record a movie? What if I want to put a movie on my computer? You know, I got my HD PVR or whatever. And what if I want to put it on there? And I want to put it like Spanish subtitles, you know, for my parents to see or something. Because I don't like my parents being in my room the whole time. I like my privacy. Yes, guys, I live in a basement. Come on. I used to live upstairs, but, you know, we had a friend move in, and I was like, I'm going to move downstairs. All right, I'm going to go downstairs. It's actually a little bit, it's not as quiet. It's still very private, though. But it's not quiet because, man, there's always watch people watching TV down here. They got a TV down here as well, so they was watching TV here. They like copied the layout with the top floor down here. So they got a kitchen in the basement. They got two rooms in the basement. They got, what do you call it? They got a bathroom in the basement. They got a small like living room kind of thing. Plus the laundry thing. It's just, they got a little bit of everything, which is good. ISO, what is it? Kodamon? Kodamon needs to get to level 4 pronto. Pronto, sir. Alright, so let's see here. I was thinking of which Digimon to get later on. Once I get them to ultimate form, I may get rid of Renamon and try and get, not Greymon, but I may try and get Monmon. Get rid of Renamon and get Monmon instead. I like Monmon. Like, I'm gonna go to that dual island place. I didn't remember about that. I'm gonna go to that dual place. To that dual island place. And go fight against, the ultimate form of Monmon. And whenever you beat the ultimate form of Monmon, you get his, DNA. And then you take it back to this one guy. And I believe he gives you, like, a level 1 rookie form of it, rookie version of him. And then, I mean, by that time it's easy, you know, you need to start the battle with them, and then you switch right away to a strong Digimon and kill the person, and they still get experience because they was in the battle, even though they did nothing. And that's how you level up weak Digimon early on. Then you just have to fight a few stronger enemies whenever they're like little champion or something, get them to an ultimate, then they're strong already. Because this game doesn't have stuff like, oh, you need to use this skill in battle so you can level it up. It's just levels. So as long as the demon levels, everything levels along with it. The strength, the attack power, everything levels up along. Alright, Codemon, level up. Let's see if you can level up, son. Jesus, this guy's taking his sweet butt time. That didn't rhyme. Alright, so how long have I been playing? This person's still looking in the hole. Let me go to the right side. This Codemon is taking a while. Alright. I don't want to go all the way over there because there's some stronger Digimon up here. I can run around here. Look at that giant melon. Watermelon. In the water. I'm going to jump in it. It's a watermelon. See, it's a melon, but it's in the water. So it's a watermelon. It's Speedy DJ. Somebody just logged in. I believe Codemon has like a, he's like pretty balanced. He has a, what do you call it? Man. I think he has the highest health out of all the Digimons. Or is that, man, this guy still has some level. Is that, I don't know, Agumon? Wire Forest Entrance. Alright, let's go back over there. I don't know if I want to move a little bit ahead. If I do move a little bit ahead, I might get killed. Man, I might have to come out here again. Is there anybody that would like to play me cards? I don't know. Yeah, I spent this whole first part of the game doing that preliminaries kind of thing. Trying to get buffer. How much money do I got? 796. Alright, let's try and walk it this way. See if I find strong enemies. Oh my god. Awesome. Just waiting for a fight. Ah, look at this punk. Can't beat me, punk. I'm too good for you. Alright, see if you can level me up. Level me up. Alright, hopefully this is enough experience to level me up. I don't know. Why is this taking so long to level compared to the others? What level is he? Oh, he's level 4 already. Level 3, I mean. I thought he was level 2. I was like, why is it taking so long to be level 3? I was thinking about Patamon. Sorry, guys. Sorry. I am dumb. I made a mistake. It was like in Black Ops. Mistakes were made. Oh, this is guy I wanted to play. Let me go just get this box real quick. I got a buckler. Alright. So, when we want to equip an item, go to status. Let's equip this buckler to Codemon and increase his defense, I believe. Equipment. Body. Is it body or is it head? Where does it go? Right or left arm? See, I'm thinking Codemon as myself. I'm right-handed, so I will hold the shield with my left. Yeah. That sounds about right. Yeah. Sorry, guys. So I had like a little speech spasm right there. Spaz. Oh my god, guys. I had an experience with a hater. I had a hater experience. Oh, let's duel some other time. They don't want to duel me. They're too scared. You scared, MFR. You scared. That's a song. Man, why is this weak people appearing all the way over here? I know if I walk a little bit further, they're going to get stronger. So I don't want to go that far. Alright, let's keep going. Oh my god, I had a break. As soon as I'm done recording this whole first part, I gotta go cut the grass. And man, Monday school starts. It's awesome. College is awesome. I want to meet a nice lady who is going to like me for who I am. It's messy. That's a weird conversation to have in gaming media. I want to meet a nice lady. I want to meet a nice lady that likes me for who I am and doesn't judge me for playing games. Actually, you know what? Let's put it this way. My number one interest in life is women. I'm saying it right now. My number one interest in life is women. But since I try to keep myself controlled when it comes to that matter, I try to keep myself occupied. And since my hobbies are playing games and playing board games, card games, video games, working out. Those are my hobbies. Since those are my hobbies, I try to do them as much as possible. That way I don't think about women. There we go. That makes sense. That's about right. That sums up what I'm all about. You know, women. When I don't want to think about women, I try to keep myself busy with something. I haven't read a book in a while. I should read a book. Alright, this guy's dead. I don't know if I want to work out my attack yet. Alright, there is something I wanted to see. I wanted to work out my attack, but I don't know if I want to yet. Because I wanted to show you guys how you work out your attack. But there was one slight little problem. Usually whenever I played the game before, what I would do is I would save the game before I trained my Digimon. And if I failed in my training and I didn't get as many points as I'd like to, I would restart and load drop from the same spot. That way I would try it again until I got it perfect. And I would keep doing that with every 10 to 5 points. That way I always got like full power, you know, full attack or whatever for it. So I might show you guys exactly what I mean. I might show you guys a small example of the training. And then I'll turn off the game and train or whatever. Do it. That way I don't got to record it. That little possession where I'm actually resetting and restarting the way that I can get it perfect if I fail it. And then when you guys see me load it up again, I'll show you guys exactly my attack power. And I'll show you guys, I'll be like, oh, okay, I'm telling you right now that I did that. That way you guys know I didn't cheat or anything. I mean, even though there's no way to cheat, I'm playing this on my PS3. How the hell am I going to play? I'm going to cheat this game. Incredible. You guys kill me. I'm saying I'm cheating. I'm going to kick your butt. Get out of my face. Just get out of my face. I don't want to see you no more before I smack you. It's like, no, daddy, no. Mr. Deeds. Anybody ever seen that movie, Mr. Deeds? When that guy was like, you were talking bad in front of women. It's like, and then the guy takes out his belt. And the guy's like a big grown man, like a football player. And he goes like, no, daddy, no. It's about to smack him with the belt. That you were talking bad in front of women. No, daddy, no! Don't hit me! Don't mess up my beautiful face. It's the only thing I got to live for. That would suck. You know, if your only talent in life is being beautiful, and somebody smacks in the face and tears you up, you're screwed in life. That's why you should be an all-around person. Well, you got many assets to support you. Alright. Friendly advice from your host, Overlord Tico. Alright, let's see here. Let's put Patamon first. Ranamon's got a lot of mana points. Yeah, she got 411 at level 4. She gets a lot more, but Patamon is probably going to have a lot too. You know, I've never gotten used to seeing the Mon at the end of each one of them. I know it means they're monsters. They call it a monster. Rena monster. Paddle monster. They don't look like monsters in their first form. Kind of weird. Look at them. Each time I stop, look at them. You're killing me. These guys are crazy. They can't hold me back. Alright, Come on, come on. Alright, battle. Patamon, it's time to level you up. Alrighty. Spectack, Boom Bubble. Alright, one thing is, you guys can see that little... You guys can see where my health is at. And you see that, you see where it has the health at 3 squares. Those 3 squares mean you're 3 Digimons. The blue means the Digimon has full health. The green means they have taken a little bit of damage. So those two are Renamon and Kodamon, the other two. And the blue one is Patamon because it's the one, the big one I'm using right now. You guys see that black bar underneath it with that little glitter in it? That glitter, I believe it fills up every time you do a hit. Or every time you get hit or something like that, slightly. If you get hit by a lot of damage, it fills up even higher. When that full bar, when that bar completely fills up, your Digimon goes into like burst mode or something like that, and he forces himself to level up to Digimon into his next Digivolution. So Patamon would turn to a champion. If he was a champion, he would turn to his ultimate. If he was his ultimate, he would turn to a Mega. And I believe if you're a Mega, you just get your I don't know. I don't know what you get if you're a Mega. I can't remember. I don't know if you even get anything. It's weird. Number 3, awesome. So yeah, that is something I just wanted to say to you guys, you know. So also, some Digimons have the ability to, when you tag from one Digimon to another, they can DNA Digivolve. And when they tag, instead of tagging, you can click to tag and fuse up with another Digimon that you got, you know, in your list that you're able to fuse with. Each Digimon is only allowed to have 3 Digivolutions at a time. So Patamon could have, his first form, second and third, all in 3 different slots. Same for each one of the other two. And then they could switch to any of them, anytime. So that's pretty good. And then if you get more Digivolutions from like another branch of another Digimon or whatever, then you would need to go to the Digivolve laboratory or whatever to change that. I don't know. I'm just spitting knowledge out here. Boom Bubble! Incredible. This guy is so good! That's what they said about me. This guy's so good. I cannot believe he beat him with one hit. I'm going to become the number one in the world. Have you guys ever seen that movie, The One? Jet Li? It's one of my favorite movies ever. You know, it's not too bad what he was doing, you know. It's like, it's true. He wasn't like killing other people. He's killing himself. If I could do the same thing, I would do it. I'd be like, don't worry, man. I'm just going to kill you. We're only going to become one. We're gonna have the same thoughts, same everything. We're gonna have all the knowledge. We're gonna be one person, and we're gonna rule the universe. We're gonna be so fast that bullets can't hit us. We're gonna be so strong we can hit a wall and break it little pieces. We can bend steel. It's incredible. I know, guys. I'm evil. But it's okay. I thought my social studies teacher used to say whenever I was in middle school, and he said, "You guys are doing bad, and you're gonna get it, and you're gonna." That was one of my Mr. Jackson. I believe that was his name, Mr. Jackson. One of my favorite teachers ever. He was strict, but he was cool. Mr. Jack, I believe he said something like whenever we were doing bad, it was like a test coming up or something, and he was seeing that we wasn't studying and anything. It's like a lot of you are gonna fail the test, but that's okay. He will say, but that's okay. that's how he ended every sentence he said. That's when he was trying to tell us something. He was like, but that's okay. And he would say it in that tone, but that's okay. Like that. Every time. I'm like, man, this guy's so cool. He was old too. He was like 50 something. I don't know. 40 something or 50. He was like 50 something. I think from what I remember. I haven't seen him in years. From what I remember though. It'd be pretty cool to encounter him someday, you know, find him, see him someday, be like, what's up, how you been, oh, you still alive, that's cool, man, that's cool, I'm glad I got to see you before, you know. Yeah, guys, yeah, you know, life is too short, You know, you could be healthy now, then tomorrow some jackass decides to hit you with a car and you die. And then that's it. You're done. And that's all he wrote. Life is too short, you got to enjoy it. Not really. Life is too short, but you can't enjoy it. It's just frustration. There's too much frustration in life. I believe life was a lot more simpler 200 years ago, you know? It was just about food and stuff. But nowadays, you gotta pay taxes. There's so many laws. You get in trouble for anything you do. You can't spank your kids anymore. How the hell are you supposed to teach them manners and respect? I'm not trying to say beat them to death. Spank them a little bit, though. I'm for hitting kids, but I believe sometimes there's some other option. I don't know. You can agree, you can disagree. Just let me know in the comments. You know, you guys can say whatever. You can agree to disagree. How about that? You can agree to disagree. That's all I gotta say about that, guys. Sometimes it's just no other way to make it work. Twistsome 2009. Twisted Metal. Twisted Metal hasn't come out yet. I don't know what he's talking about. Alright, so I'm pretty happy that my game's still working perfect. Let's see how much I got. 69. I believe if I can do two more of those attacks, then I'm gonna go save again. Or I might just show you guys the the training thing, so you guys can see exactly how it's like, so you can see if you fail or not, how it works, if you fail, if you don't fail. So I'm gonna go to the training thing right now. Punk, how dare you hit me in the face. All right so I'm gonna do that. Boom bubble. Oh my god. I think, and after I show you that, guys, I'm probably gonna save the game too. I don't know. Let me check how long this video is so far. Wow, 1 hour and 7 minutes. That is incredible. I did not know I had that kind of power. Ah, Jesus. Come on, man. Come on. Don't do this to me. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Cut me some slack, man. I'm not gonna be able to make it. I think another fight's gonna pop up. I'm gonna have to fight it without having my power. Alright, so I had like 69 points left or something. I don't even know how much blue oil costs. I never look. I just click, 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 click. I just keep clicking X every time. I don't even know how much blue oil costs, so I don't know if I got enough mana points still. I press start real quick. I only got 9. Not enough for anything. Alright, so this is the training gym. I'll show you guys the training. Do you want to work out? Yes, I love working out. It's like one of my favorite things to do in life. Wow. As you can see, Patamon lacks a very big factor, you know. He's kind of weak in attack. So let's go ahead and train his punch. So as you guys can see, over here we can train to study. That's your knowledge. You can train to jump rope, your speed, yoga, spirit, defense, punch, your strength, you know, defense. Okay, so the way this works is, for example, we got, for every level that your rookie Digimon gets, you get 5 T points, TP, and that's training points. Alright, so then we go in here. One thing I gotta tell you guys, as you guys can see, we only got 5 things available to train right now. We can't train fire resistance, none of those things. If you want to train those things, you got to go to another gym later on in the game. You click like R1 or L1 and another section appears that tells you like more options to, you know, train or whatever. So let's click here real quick. Alright, so we have options. We can only waste 1 and we can try it. So pretty much we can use 1 and try and get do a tryout, the training tryout, and that's going to give us, what do you call it? That's gonna give us some more strength. But if we use like 10, it's gonna give us 10 times as much, you know. It's supposed to give us like 10 times as much, you know. That's so you can get stronger faster, you know. You don't have to waste that much time doing it. You know, you don't want to do this like 10 times when you could just do this one time and get as many points. You know what I mean? But I only do this whenever I'm sure that, whenever I'm sure that I'm going to get like all across perfect, you know, get as many points as possible right off the bat. That's just me. So I don't know. But just for teaching purposes, I'm going to show you guys what quick TP one. And for each one of these things, I don't know. I haven't really gotten the technique around. I don't remember exactly how the technique works. I don't know if you're supposed to just let them train, or you're supposed to like tap X every time they do something. For example, we punch. Every time he punches, what I do is I tap X. I don't know if that works. I don't remember. I can't remember. I gotta look this up as soon as I'm done with this video. So, but just look it up if you guys are gonna play this game. You know, look it up. The best way to have them do the perfect thing for me is just the timing. Yes, click X. But I can't remember if that's right or whatever. So I'm gonna just look it up right here. But for this purpose, I'm just telling you guys, you know, this is what I think. It might not be right, but this is what I think, and I'm just explaining to you guys how to do it. Alright, so, as you guys can see, you'll see it right now. I got hit at the end. Alright, so as you guys can see, each time you get it right, you get a circle. You get an okay circle. If you get three in a row okay circles, you get a fourth try. If you get any excess in the first three tries, you don't get a fourth try. So that's what I was saying. If you use 10 points, you want to get all across perfect. That way you get as many points as possible right off the bat. So that is all I gotta say about that. So that was just a small tryout. So that was pretty good. My power went up by 5. See, if I would have done this with 10, it would have went up like 50 points probably. So yeah, that is all I gotta say about that, guys. All right, anyways, this is a pretty good try for a start hit time. So, all right, let's go back to the city real quick. We don't care about these guys. All right, let me see something. Let me see if I got an item that can heal their mana points. I don't know if they actually give me an item, or do I actually have to go buy it right off the bat? They just gave me a power charge. That's not even enough for anything. All right, so I just guess I'm gonna go in the city. I'm gonna go in the city and save the game. Oh my god! All right, I'm not gonna end. All right, while the little loading thing is going when it's saving the game, I'm gonna go to the bathroom and take a small piece. That's all I gotta do. Actually, there's nothing more I gotta do. I just wanna do that because, you know, I've been holding it since I started playing the game. I didn't think it was gonna work, and it's working. So I'm just kidding. I knew it was working, but I didn't think I was gonna have to go that quick. Usually I try to hold it for a while. You see how cool I am, guys? This is a good conversation we're all having. All right, so let's go ahead and click save. And as soon as I click to save, I'm gonna go. And I might take like a few seconds over whatever it is on there, so just chill out. Alright, guys, that wasn't that long, was it? I'm back. Alright. Yeah, I didn't want to just split the video up into another part. Screw it, I'm gonna keep playing. Nothing's gonna happen, anyways. The game turns off, the game freezes, or whatever. I already saved, anyways. you guys are gonna be with me. We're all cool. We're cool peoples. All right, let's go in here real quick. This is where we gotta buy our items and such. I gotta buy some items so I can heal my mana points. Cause I can't always just keep going back to the city. And this is the guy who sells them. Wizard Bond. Alright, let's see. Poison. No, it's not that. Strength up, defense down. Power blood. Alright, where is it? Is that even one like that? I can't remember. I don't think there's anything to heal my mana points. There is this thing right here. Mana points. Life. Too bad. I guess not. Maybe it's later in the game. I'm not sure. I guess we're going to have to go without mana points for now. No, we kind of have to keep going back into one of those inns. Alright, here's that weapon, dude. No, we don't care about him yet. We're going to come here later. As soon as we get our Digimons to level 5 and all of them are champions, we're going to go back here. Don't worry. We're going to come back here, guys. Oh, damn it. Squares. Load faster. So I didn't know where I was going. Alright. Run. Man, you know what would be funny? If I had the stamina of a game character, you know, I could run non-stop. Even if I wasn't the fastest person, I would never get tired. You have to like unplug me from my battery or something. I don't know. I'm crazy stuff like that. But now Patamon's gonna last a while before his energy runs out. I could try to go over there and try and beat a champion Digimon. That's actually pretty strong. But I think he's beatable right about now. By me. I think he's about beatable, but I'm not sure. I don't want to risk it. I'm gonna just wait till I'm a champion. When I'm a champ, I'll be a lot stronger. The Patamon is mainly, his main focus is just healing, so. He's pretty cool though. But yeah, his main focus is healing. Alright, let's talk to a guy over here first. You know, screw it. Let's go over here. What's the worst thing that could happen? Oh, get killed. I forget. Don't worry, I can just escape the battle. Even though I have not used the option yet. Alright, let's go down here real quick. Alright, battle appeared. Let's see who it is. Quelamon, I believe his name. Quelamon, yep. Alright, let's use the boom bubble. Now this guy's a little bit stronger than regular Digimon, so that's what I was saying about being on this side. I'm using the boom bubble. Let's see how much damage I do with this. Yeah, it's not too bad. Alright, let's see how much damage he does, though. Ah, too sad. Alright. Let's go ahead and run away. Come on, don't do it. You punk, how dare you? I don't want him to do Renamon is stronger against him. See, this is why I didn't want to go on this side. Are you serious? He's gonna attack me right away? Come on, at least give me a chance to get up. What? You died right away? See, this is what I was telling you guys. What is the worst thing that could happen? Oh my god. See, why? Why does this kind of things happen to me? I can't do it. Besides, his main attack is a water attack. Let's see if he can run away. He can survive this attack. I'm pretty sure. Run away. Yes. You are the man. I think you are the man. Alright, so I just wanted to go here. Alright, before we come here to talk to this guy, we first had to go over there where I got the card packs or whatever. Talk to the Divermon that we saw in the city. And then this guy tells you about the card, whatever. About these boot thingies. He's like, Cardmon, and Cardmon is a Digimon that appears in the trees, and you can actually get some boots, like kick boots or whatever, that you can use to put those boots on, and pretty much the whole point is you hit the tree with the boot, and the Cardmon comes out, and you fight it, and when you beat it, you gain experience, and they give you a booster pack. So, alright, let's go ahead and do something here. This is not good. Alright, let's go ahead and kill this guy, this bad boy right here. Man, I should have bought some power disc. Alright, hopefully I can reach here really quick. Yes, awesome. Alright, no other fight. Because up here, up there, there's a different Digimon. If you're in the bottom part, closer to the water, a Coilumon appears. But if you're in on the top part, a different Digimon appears. It's a Digimon that's like a dinosaur. So, yeah, we didn't want to fight that one. See, this is what I'm saying. It's like, I said, what's the worst thing that could happen? And both my Digimons died. And the other one was about to die one more hit. Telling you guys, man. I just got that bad luck, man. I got to try and play. I always got to be careful. That's why when I play like Yu-Gi-Oh and everything, I always play like decks that are like slow paced, you know, that slow down what everybody does. That way I can control the pace of the game. I'm a control freak. I like to control everything. I like to control the pace everything goes. All right, tactics is now online. Offline, or I don't know. I didn't look. I'm checking back this video. I had to look at my cell phone. Let me see my. I don't know if I turned it off or something. I haven't heard it today. Oh, I got 3 new messages. I knew it was something up with it. Alright, put it on vibrate real quick. So you can just vibrate and I go off. I don't like my cell phone going off when I'm playing or when I'm recording or whatever. It's annoying. It's distracting. Alright, so let me read my messages while I go ahead and move this guy around a little bit. I'm in a circle. See if he finds anything. I gotta run some errands. There's a girl. I was talking to on Facebook. Alright, let's see here. Alright, boom, bubble. Finish him off. I got another friend. Got place. What are you up to, man? Then Colossus. All right, Colossus or HDPVR. My friend was asking me what was the best capture device to buy, and I told him the Colossus or the HDPVR. If you go on the Haposh website, the Colossus costs you $150, and it has a it's meant to be built. It's a built-in recorder for your computer, so desktop computers only. And pretty much what it is it costs $150, $160, because $150, $160 records up to 1080i format. And it's got a component and HDMI input, but it only up to 1080i resolution, you know? So 720p and 1080i are the max resolutions. Preferably 720p, because 1080i is bad for playing games that are fast-paced, because the image starts to get kind of bad. Alright, but anyways, let's see here. Man, what the hell? Why are they watching TV over there? It's weird. Alright, I'm gonna fix that. Fixing something, cause I don't like the noise from the TV. The other room coming through. All right, but let me think. What was I thinking? All right, the Colossus is $150, $160, but it's only for built-in computer, so you can't carry it around. It's not for a laptop. It's only for a desktop. So you gotta have a desktop right next to your recording stuff. You know, that's the way it works. That's why it's less. But the HDPVR is essentially the same thing, but it's a box. It's like a tuner box. and you can actually take that anywhere, put it with a laptop, put it with a desktop, anywhere, you know, put it anywhere, connect it to anything. But it doesn't got an HDMI input, and it records the same formats and everything. Although the Colossus records to on a higher bitrate, the highest bitrate for the HDPVR is at 13.5 megabits per second, and for the Colossus is like 20. It records at a higher bitrate, but I don't know why anybody would like a higher bitrate unless they're playing a 1080p, which the Colossus cannot record 1080p, so it's kind of useless to put it that high. It just makes the files huge for no dang reason. Yeah. There should be no reason besides there is no place online that even has that much bitrate, you know? I think YouTube only has up to like 8 megabits. The bitrate is 8 megabits or something. 8 megabits per second bitrate, the highest bitrate on YouTube. Or 10. I think for 1080p it's like 10. 10 megabits per second, that's the highest. 10,000 kilobits per second. That's the highest bitrate for YouTube, I think. I don't know. When you're playing 1080p. So, I mean, it's useless to put something like 20. Why would you need something like that? I mean, if you're playing like a really fast-paced game, let's say on Real Tournament is really fast-paced, you need a bitrate like that, probably, if you don't want any frame rate drops or anything. But then when you're going to put it online for YouTube or anything, you don't need it that high. You still need a 10 at most. I think 10 megabits per second is the standard for 1080p, so. And 8 is the standard for 720p. So it's not too bad. 12, 13, that's pretty good. But no place online really really needs that much, you know. Doesn't really affect the overall quality whenever you do put it on the internet, so it's kind of weird. So it's like a waste of money. I don't want to say it's a waste of money, but it is a waste of money. I mean, you already got the device. I mean, it is a waste of space, a waste of time. Because all the bitrate, increasing the bitrate that high is going to do, it's going to make it look good whenever you're playing the raw file on your computer, make it look super smooth if you got a good computer with like a quad core processor or something like that. But aside from that, it's not going to be good. It's just not going to matter whenever online, it's not going to matter. It might matter if you're doing like a live feed, you're doing a lot of live footage or whatever. It might make it look really good, live footage. But aside from that, you don't really need more than 12, 13 megabits per second. So I think the HDPVR is the better option. But I do like the HDMI input that, what do you call it? I do like the HDMI input and output that the Colossus has. Even though it's only for desktop. I do like it a lot. It's pretty good. It's a pretty good option. I don't know why I just did that. Alright, let's see how much damage he does. Alright, let me attack him again. He needs 3 attacks. He needs to get stronger. He needs 3 attacks still to be able to kill this guy. He's the weakest one in the whole game. So Patamon needs his attack increased big time. It'd be funny if I went through the whole game. Alright, I guess 2 attacks. It'd be funny if I went through the whole game without training my Digimons on anything. That'd be something. This guy's taking his sweet ass time on leveling up and becoming a champion. See if he gets a little bit of power or something, you know. Strength, punch. Jesus. So yeah, they should just probably make an HDPVR with the HDMI, add a tag of like $30 on it. Cost $200 right now. I'll pay $230. I think $230 is a pretty good price for a slightly bigger HDPVR with HDMI input and output. You know, everybody's going HDMI now. I mean, even though HDMI is only importing whenever you're playing 1080p, that's what I'm saying. Why put HDMI on it if it doesn't accept 1080p? Why? Bet you later on that people that have the what do you call it? I know. I mean, it's not gonna matter. I'm just gonna keep waiting. I'm just gonna keep waiting a couple more years till they have 1080p, and then I'm gonna buy the next 1080p thing. Cause these people, these people from Hapash, they're probably just milking that thing, you know, trying to get more money now with this new Colossus thing. But probably in a year and a half from now or something, they're probably gonna release something that has 1080p on it for like $300. I was gonna save my money and wait for that. No. I'm gonna save my money. This guy's still not leveling up. This is pissing me off. Alright, he needs to level up, man. Angelmon, where you at, boy? Where you at, Angelmon? Angelmon is his champion form, if you guys don't remember. He's one of the very first Digimons that ever appeared in the series. My mom was asking me if I wanted to eat. I was going to say yes, but if I eat, I'm not going to talk as much. Unless you guys are tired of me talking. I don't have a lot of interesting things to say. I'm kind of boorish. Boorish person. SpaghettiOs. Alright. Oh man, this sucks. This guy's like, he's out of energy now. Jesus. I gotta switch Kodemon now. Gotta switch Kodemon and keep playing with Kodemon because he has his full thing. At least Kodemon wastes less on his power. You know, his power only costs like 20 mana points. Even though he has less overall mana points, less max mana points, his power does cost less. So he still gets to do it a good 13 times. So we'll get a good 13 battles out of him. Let's try and multiply 13 times 6. Jesus. What is that, like 78 or something? I don't know. I'm doing like quick math in my head. You know how you do quick math? You always think of the smallest numbers and you just add up from there. I never think about big numbers. If something has a lot of zeros, I just take away the zeros and count the rest of my head. You know, in Cuba, they teach you to do everything by either by when you know, let's say, thinking about it or just doing it on paper. So people are a lot more competent when it comes to solving math things or whatever quicker, because I don't need a computer or a laptop or I don't know, calculator all the dang time, every time. Now, you know, it's good to know the process, but you gotta be able to do it by hand as well. Not just put the things in, like put in the equation and let the equation solve it for you. It's like, oh, you know exactly what it stands for and everything, you know exactly how it is, but have you actually ever done it yourself and see how it actually works? Perform the whole process yourself, you know. That's the only way to be sure, really. I think they have yet to make a computer that can follow like whatever a person can do. You know, computers can do accurate things, but they're only as accurate as what the information you put in it. So if you mess up somewhere in anything you're inputting, then you get it wrong, you know. So that's where computer error comes in. Because computers can only be as good as the person that's using them. So if the person using the computer makes an error, then the computer fails. Everything else from there is gonna fail. So that's just bad. Oh my god, it's so hot in my room. I'm gonna tell my dad to turn on the air conditioner. I think he has it off because the air conditioner has been acting up. Something weird. I think that the Pyramon thingy turns into like a giant mammoth or something later on in the game. I'm gonna look it up later whenever I stop playing. Hop all start playing and go do cut the grass and everything. Go eat, take a shower. Then I'm gonna come back and keep playing. I'm gonna keep running around this thing until a battle appears. Now, I get tired of staying in one place. There we go. Technique. Can't wait till I go to a boss battle. Boss battles are awesome. I love boss battles. Because boss battles are really fun. You get a lot more, what do you call it? The music is just epic, you know. When you play like a Digimon boss battle, you see the music is epic. And then when you play like a trainer boss, then the music is told. So it's also epic. It's like epic in the kind of like, whenever you play a Digimon, like a single Digimon boss, it's like epic in the way of like trying to be creepy epic. And then when you play a trainer, then it's epic in the way in trying to be cool epic, you know, but like kind of like a hip-hop kind of thing, hip-hop techno kind of beat thingy mix. It's pretty good actually. He's asking me how much they are, the Colossus and the... Alright, I'll put 200 and 160. 160. Alright, 200 and 160. Alright, that's about right. So, I guess he's trying to start his own stuff. He's one of the guys, he's known me since 2 years already, since I've been like 2.5, almost 3 years on YouTube right now. He's known me for, I've been 3 years on YouTube right now. If some of you guys don't know, I actually had a previous channel before. This wasn't my first channel. My channel was Overlord Tico and it got suspended by YouTube. When all the copyright stuff started. And it wasn't like I had a lot of copyright. I actually have very little copyright. The copyright I had wasn't even like visual copyright, it was like music stuff. But I had like a couple visual things, like very, very early when the first times I got on YouTube, I uploaded a clip of like Family Guy or Robot Chicken or something. It was Robot Chicken, Dragon Ball Z Christmas, Robot Chicken the Christmas, whatever, you know, the Dragon Ball Z Christmas where they fight Miss Santa and stuff. Yeah, that's what it was. And what happened was, I did, whenever YouTube back in the day didn't have so many things about it, so as soon as they gave me that little notice up, whatever, you know, it was like 2000, early 2008, late 2007, so I just took it down, you know. They didn't give me a strike or nothing, they just told me to take it down because it was prohibited or whatever, and I took it down. Then like half a year to a year later, when I was playing Star Ocean 4, I upload the ending to Star Ocean 4 because I beat the whole game, and they tell me the same thing, tell them to take it down, it's prohibited or whatever. I'm like, alright, I'll take it down. So I took it down, and then, what do you call it? And then like three, four, five, I don't know, a few months later, I was at that was when all the copyright, all the copyright was already starting, you know, all the music was getting muted. I deleted everything that I had with copyright, everything that had with music and everything, deleted it, got rid of it. So I didn't have no problems with the copyright. I had nothing, no content ID, nothing. I deleted all my Yu-Gi-Oh! Beaters. I had Nightwish music in it, everything. Then I tried to redo some videos, but not that many. I was like, you know what? I'm just forget about it. Later on, I'll do it whenever I feel like it. Whenever I feel like redoing all that shit, all those things. And then all of a sudden, I get two copyright strikes in my account from those two previous things I told you before. From that Robot Chicken thing, and then that Star Ocean, the ending. And I'm like, those things already happened like months or like a year ago. One of them like a year, the other one months ago. And they gave me a strike for it, like months after it and a year after it. I'm like, what is this? Why would you give me a strike for things that have already happened? Like, it wasn't when even like copyright wasn't that big of a deal, you know? I just took them down because the system told me to. That wasn't blocked or anything. It wasn't like not allowed to upload. It was that they just asked me to take them down and people couldn't view it. It was blocked worldwide. But I could view it, but it was blocked worldwide. But what do you call it? So I took it down. I mean, I'm like, all right, so it's cool. And then I get that copyright strike. I'm like, what? What is this? And I mean, there's no way you can appeal it, though. I mean, how are you going to appeal it to? I mean, you know you did it, but why? I don't understand. Why did we give you a strike so much time later, you know? And then a little bit later, I got another strike. And that's it. You know, with three strikes, that's when they have the right to, like, suspend your account or whatever. So, yeah, that's what happened. So, yeah, guys, it's just bad. That's what happens. That's what happened with my channel. And all those videos went away. I had, if some of you guys know from me back there, like this guy that I was talking to, I was making only videos of Yu-Gi-Oh, Star Ocean, Need for Speed, and Yu-Gi-Oh, Star Ocean, Need for Speed, Dragon Ball Z. And yeah, that's it. Those four games. And I had over 200 videos of Star Ocean 3. Like beating every single boss in the game with like on with ultimate difficulty with like one character, with like each single character in the game. Each boss. I was like, man, I beat in this game so many times. I had beat in the game like 20 times, recorded everything I did against each boss, recorded like a lot of parts of my walkthrough and stuff, recorded puzzles and things. Man, so much stuff I did, and all of it went down the drain. I don't know if I were to actually like put things up right now again of Star Ocean, people would actually remember that I still put up things of Star Ocean. It's not that I don't love Star Ocean. You know, Star Ocean 3 till the end of time is still my favorite game to date. But I've played it about 35 times right now. Beat it 35 times. And I don't know if I want to restart it all over again. And then if something might happen later. I mean, I know I'm sure. Right now, I'm completely sure. I know exactly what to do about copyright. It's like, what if they make some stupid thing now where you can have nothing at all? Everything's got to be completely 100% original. Otherwise, it can't be on YouTube. I'm like, what? What is YouTube for? It's not YouTube. It's like company tube or whatever. You know, they own everything. You can't put nothing that's original there, you know. Because people all the time, like, for example, they do remixes of like songs or something. Or like do dances. Or like, I don't know. Or like reenact the show. Do song covers or something. I don't know. Things like that. I mean, for example, this interface I'm using right here, for example, let's see right here. Let's see, how would they say this is copyright? Let's see, oh, you're playing a game that is owned by this company. Let's see, this thing I'm doing right here is not unique to, it's unique to the game, but it's not something that's like, for example, like a video, they have like a system. The system actually picks up the video and tells you, oh, this video is actually in the system, and they have an exact record of what the video exactly looks like. So the moment it picks up any video in the system that looks exactly like it and matches the exact profile, it automatically deletes it. You know, it says the copyright thing, and then the sound, it matches the sound and everything. Yeah. But how does it know, for example, how would a system, if they ever decided to get so butthole about it, about copyright, how would they know that exactly that little motion I was doing there, just going in a circle and me talking over the music and stuff like that, know that that's the game? I mean, let's just say that some casualty, they decided to get that anal about copyright. No, it'd be crazy. It'd be crazy if they did. Because I bet you YouTube would just go down the drain. Everybody would just leave YouTube. Because they wouldn't be able to upload anything. Very few people actually are very creative to upload things, you know? I mean, I know people that are creative, but it's just that not everybody's that creative. So, I mean, I'm pretty creative, but I like doing games. This is what I like. So, if something like that ever happened, I'll probably leave YouTube. But that's just me, guys. That's just me. That's just my personal opinion. What if I want to do a dancing video? What if I got a new dance for like a song, and I want to put up the video, me dancing, and then with the song in the background? Yeah, but this video's gonna be taken down. It's crazy. For example, what if? Oh, I think there was a woman who tried to sue YouTube or something like that, because for example, she had like a home video. Because I guess some people were doing that before. Whenever they for example, they had a video, like they would have a video, you know, and instead of actually keeping record of the video or whatever, yeah, load up quicker. Instead of actually keeping record of the video, they would just, what do you call it, just put it on YouTube and keep it on there, you know? What? They don't believe YouTube's gonna go anywhere, because YouTube's really big, so they would just put it on there and just leave it on there, you know? So, for example, what if, I don't know, I think it was something, this one was something about her like, two-year-old son or something. It was something weird like that. Her two-year-old son was, dancing to, like, a little song or something like that, and she recorded it because it was cute or whatever. She put it on there, she left it out there. I guess she didn't have another copy of it or something. I don't know, something like that. Let's say something like that. And then, whenever the YouTube copyright stuff started, they took it down. And it's like, you know, I would be enraged, because if that's like a memory of my life, you know? It's my son growing up, you know, one of the first funny things they did or whatever, you know? You would want to keep that memory. So, why would a company have the right to take down your full video just because of the background song, you know? Why not just give you a notice, you know, before they do it, well, you can download it and then, you know, you get rid of it or whatever, you know, like give you like some, what do you call it, some leisure time or something. I don't know what I'm trying to say, something like that. You guys understand what I mean. Is this YouTube, man? YouTube has really, if YouTube ever, I mean, I don't think copyright can get any worse than it is right now, and if it ever does, YouTube's not gonna be fun for anybody at all. I'm just saying. Even for me, I love YouTube. I love being on YouTube. I love YouTube more than Facebook. And I don't think I would like it that much anymore. Alright, so I'm gonna just get this much money real quick. Get 11 power disk. Alright, so I gotta go ahead and keep fighting, I guess, guys. Sorry guys, it's taking a while, but don't worry. It's all gonna be okay, it's all going to end soon. Alright, so let's keep running. Run, 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 run. Codemon, Pedamon, Redemon. Run, run, run. Alright, I got a message. I got a text message. Let's see what it says. It says, thanks. Alright, so I guess he got money. Guess he got the money for it right now. Alright, so, oh. The thing I forgot to do when I went in here. But forget it. I'm not gonna do it now anyways. It was something I gotta show you guys about that little kid that we talked to. He was talking about the Cardamom boots. We're gonna go where the Eam was at later on. As soon as we get at least two of these guys to level champion level, Patamon and Cardamom, we're gonna get them to champion level first. And then I don't know what we're gonna do about Renamon. I think she'll have enough experience. Yeah, she has enough experience to do that power a million times. I mean, enough mana points. Sorry, magic mana. Points. I don't know. Kunemon, 330 damage. Kunemon is defeated. Alright, just a little bit more experience, guys. I don't think it was that much longer. And then we'll get his first transformation. You know, Cardamon is my favorite Digimon in this game. That's why I always choose the balance pack. I should always choose the balance pack just because I want Cardamon. I don't want any other Digimon. I just want Cardamon. And his Mega form is my favorite form of all the Digimons in this game. Alright, so it's a little bit longer. Dinohumon. Alright, so we got these guys finally that level we wanted. Alright, so I'm gonna do one fight with it real quick. Alright, first thing we're gonna do is do status. If you wanna start your battle with the Digimon already at whatever Digivolve to whatever form you want it, you wanna go into status, click on the Digimon, see Digivolve, and then click on that, and you wanna put the battle Digivolve on. As you guys can see, it's like blue highlighted right now, so you guys can see the power boost he gains from being a rookie to being a champion. Well, it's relative, you know, it's a lot. It's not a whole lot, but it's a lot. It's more. It's not a whole lot, but it's a lot more. like a whole lot. This is maybe it's an exaggeration. Like, you know, Kruki to Mega is a whole lot. Be like at least 100 points for each factor or something like that. Alright, so you guys, I'll show you guys right now how I heal up here, already transformed. Look at my sword. I got knives and I got a big sword. And I should be able to kill this guy. I got no power, by the way. I should be able to kill him. I got my kitty. One hit. Awesome. He's not that big. He doesn't need to be, though. Alright, one thing is every 5 to 10 levels, when they get to level 5, level 10, or level 15, level 20, every 5 to 10 levels, each Digimons get like a power or something. They always get something. At least the champions or ultimates or megas, you know, they always get something like a new power, or they get to load a power, something like that. Sometimes they don't get anything, but every now and then they get something, every 5 to 10 levels. So, something to keep in mind. Serve. Alright, let's get Patamon real quick to that high level. See if he levels up quick, and then we can get his Angelmon form so you guys can see it as well. Run. Yes, he can fit right through. It fits. That's what she said. It fits. Took a long time, but we did it. That's awesome. Boom, baba. Yeah, but this guy, he's one of my guys who he loves the Star Ocean just as much as me. I don't know, man. Star Ocean is a beast of a game. But Star Ocean has 4 difficulties. I'm gonna tell you something about Star Ocean. Star Ocean has a final boss. Not the final boss of the main story. I'm talking about the final boss of the secret story at the end of the game, you know? Because once you beat the main story, you can actually load the game and you can continue and find the secret dungeons and stuff. The final boss in the game has 20 in normal difficulty, equal galaxy difficulty, has 20 million health. Then when you play him in hard difficulty, universe difficulty, she has 30 million health. Then when you play her in 4D difficulty, the very hard difficulty, she has 60 million health. So as you guys can see, the numbers are exponential. And then there's also a handicap item you can actually equip, which doubles the stats of the enemies you fight. So you guys can do the math if you wanna go for it, like challenge. Oh, also Star Ocean is a fully automatic game. I mean, what I'm trying to say about that, it's not like turn-based, it's like real time. It's a real-time game where you play with 3 characters at a time. You can either put them in, you always gotta control one. But the other two, you can either put them on manual where you have to move them yourself, you have to keep switching to move them, or you can put them on automatic where you let the computer move. The computer's kind of awful, so usually I just put them all on manual and devise a strategy for them to win. Rarely do I ever put more than one on automatic. That's where the computer uses it. Computer's terrible at doing everything. But yeah. And what do you call it? In Star Ocean, you got HP, you got MP, health points and mana points. Now the good thing I want to tell you, no, it's not a good thing. Also, you actually be like, what? That's crazy. In this game, some skills they cost mana points to use, others cost HP points to use, and not just a little bit of HP points. They cost a percentage of your total health. So if your health, if it says 10%. 10% of your health, and if your health is 2,000, it's gonna take always like 200 points, 200 of your health every time you use it. So you gotta keep that in mind. So they either use your mana points or your HP points, and enemies can hit you with MP dealing attacks that hit your MP, your mana points. And there are two ways of dying. If your HP runs out, you die, and if your mana points run out, you die. So that's what I love about Star Ocean. It's just different. It makes it, those little things just make it more challenging. I love those things. Of course, those are not the only ways to die. You know, if all your party gets turned to stone or gets paralyzed or whatever, you know, you die. You instantly lose, but you know, that's in all RPG games. But yeah, you got mana, MP deaths, and attacks cost HP points. HP percentage points to use. So yeah. This guy's taking his sweet ass time. I need to give Renamon a chance to level up. Alright, so come on. Eldorado, redo. Come on, Patamon, dude. You're holding me back. I need to get on with the game. You know, the game is holding me back. Because when I'm trying to find them, battles don't appear. And sometimes when y'all want to find them, they do appear. Man. This game is always against you. You know the bad thing? I believe when you turn off the game and you reset it, that little black bar full of glitter goes down to zero again. I think. I don't remember. So yeah, it does go down to zero. So I think it does. It goes down to zero. So you gotta start get hit again. So it fills up. Oh my god! How these guys don't hit each other? Man, they're so good. It's like they're perfect for each other. You know, they're synchronized. If Lice was this like perfect, look at these guys. All of them in a circle, perfect circle. What I was trying to say is that nothing in life is that perfect. No matter how many people train together, they're never become that synchronized where they're always the same space from each other, never hit each other or something like that. That's only in the game, guys. It's a computer. Some days computers are gonna take over humanity. Just like Terminator said. Engemon. Alright, time to turn on my Digivolution. Alright, let's press start. You can see Engemon form. Let's go to status. Alright, see Digivolve, Engemon, turn it on. Here we go. Hold on a second, let me see his his attack stats. Wow, this is incredible. His attack doesn't increase at all. I forget, guys, I'm sorry. He's like a healer demon, yeah. He is good, though. For healing, he is pretty good. He keeps himself alive. Big time. Alright, so let's run around down. I don't know. Let's see, it's a bear. I don't remember that bear. What does a bear tend to? Alright, what about Agumon? There's only three original Digimons in this game, really, though. Let me think about it, because all the other ones appeared in the Digimon anime. Kodamon is original, he didn't appear in any anime, at least the early ones. Same thing with Kumamon, the bear, and same thing with Monmon, the little monkey. Those three Digimons, they're like original to this game, at least for its time, you know? Look at this guy, he's a beast, he's an angel. Oh, that guy gets up because you're weak. Need more attack power, bro. So like I said to you guys, when I turn off the game or whatever, when I stop recording this, I'm gonna train them so I can get all their attack powers up. That way they're stronger. Because that's the only thing that matters to me. And I'll show you guys what it is. And I'll show you guys I wasted all my TP points. So you guys, some asshole over there doesn't say I cheated. Hey. People are trying to make all sorts of excuses. In YouTube, you know. There's so many haters. I do not like haters. I'm on as number one. Just gotta get her to champion level now. Let's see here. Hopefully this thing doesn't take too long. She needs a bunch of experience though. You know what? Let me go all the way over here real quick first. Yeah, I'm gonna focus on her later. Let me first go down to their El Dorado. And see if in El Dorado they'll accept me. I just wanna show you guys this real quick. Alright, let's go up here. Alright. First, let me show you the thing about the card. That little dude that went to talk to when that Coilamon thingy kicked my butt. Went to talk to about the boots of a Cardmon. He was looking for an Agumon card and he told us it was here somewhere. Oh, so it's a Gabumon card and that's what it was. Alright. So we got the Gabumon card here. So now we can go over there to where that guy was again, where we saw him kicking the tree, and we can give it to him, and you know, he gives us the information we need to know about the boots, about getting the boots. I think he gives us the boots. Oh no, he just gives us the information about the boots. Yeah. Can't remember right now. All right, so let's go into El Dorado real quick and see if they let me in the club. I don't think they let you in this club unless you have at least 2 champion Digimons or something like that. Alright, this is El Dorado where our team lovers got there. Oh, you're not a member, are you? Your Digimon isn't that cool looking, you can't be a member. What? See, he's saying my Digimon are not that cool looking yet. Alright, so when my Digimons are a little bit stronger and cool looking, I guess when all of them are champion level, whatever, they'll let me in. Whenever you do get in an El Dorado, though, it is kind of important. At least early in the game, the El Dorado is important. They got the best items for early in the game. Alright, so let me check my stats. How's everything looking? Let me go ahead and save the game real quick. Alright, first, let's stay in the inn again, save the game. Alrighty. I don't know what he said about my Digimon not being cool looking. I don't get it. I don't get it yet. I got 2 champion Digimon levels and I got 1 rookie still. Alright, maybe that's what it is. I need to all of them have him the champion. I don't remember exactly. I believe that's what it is. That's why I was trying to get the multi-champion level first. Alright, so now that we get taken care of. Alright, let's go in here again. Alright, so as soon as I get the multi champion level, let me try to talk to this guy real quick. I gotta go to Surgeon City and beat the Surgeon leader, that's what he said. You see what I'm saying about the loading thingy? No, it's taking a while now to the squares to go away. So he's loading slower, slower, and slower. Alright, I'm gonna go up here because I want to fight this Digimon over here. See if I can level up a little bit quicker. I need to speed things up. I've wasted enough of your time already with my blabbering. Hopefully it's not Coilamon. It's a plant Digimon, awesome. Vegemon, Diamond Storm meets you in the face. Pretty decent damage. Alright, this is gonna finish him off. Alright, let's see how much experience I get from that battle. 20 experience is pretty good. Hey, that's a bad moon card. You really found it. Thanks. Alright, I'll tell you about it. You can get it if you become friends with Beemon. The Beemon is so unpredictable, he's hard to find. To find Beemon, wait. Go where people meet. I'm sure someone can help you there. And the place he's talking about is the clam thingy, or the, I don't know exactly what it's called. Let me heal myself in case I fight somebody strong right here. I'm gonna stay here so I can speed things up. Over here, things are stronger. Let's see if we fight a big Digimon. I was telling you guys about. Ah, no, we're fighting this veggie again. Alright, veggie, one more hit. Alright, let's see if this does him in. I said, let's see if it does him in, because I know it's gonna do him in, but it could actually block it. You know, it could always happen. Alright, so this is pretty good. It's helping me level up a little bit quicker. Could have done this earlier, but before I went over here, I needed a good backup. But now I got a good backup because I got two champions. Because in this part right here, a couple champions do appear. I think it's a champion. It's that, that dinosaur Digimon kind of thing I told you guys about. Alright, so let's see if he appears right now. I want him to appear. Alright, hopefully he appears right now. Let's see what he can do about it. Jesus, this guy? Are you serious? Alright, let's beat him. Bait him on. This is the first time we've seen this guy. He's defeated in one hit, but he gets more experience than the other ones, I think. At least more experience than those insect thing, you know, the little moth thingy. Wormmon, whatever it's called. Come on, I don't want to go down there because then Quellamon appears. I know I can't fight that one. Not yet. Jesus, no fight, really? Man, I really hate this. I can't fight the person I want to fight. Alright, let's see this. Oh, critical hit. One hit kill, son. Cubibon. Alright, that's cool. That's awesome. We can finally switch. So we got Greenmon now. Alright, let's go back to the Super City one last time. I'm saying one last time because I don't want to go back there anymore. At least not I'm gonna stay on this side. I'm gonna go east now. So I can get my Cardmon boots thingies. Kick boots so I can kick some trees. Once I end this video, remember guys, I'm gonna go training. I'm gonna use 10 points at a time, try to get it all perfect. We should increase the power. Each time I use 10 points, you should increase their attack power by 60. So that's pretty good. So that would be a lot. That would be at least 100 points stronger when you guys see them. Alright, so this is the place that people meet that boy was talking about. The lamb shop. That's what I was trying to say. The lamb shop. And we talked to this girl, I think. I saw a Beamon the other day. He was looking for something at Wind Prairie. Alright, so as you guys can hear right there, we gotta go to Wind Prairie. Wind Prairie or whatever is all the way on the right side. So we gotta go east, all the way east. Alright, so let's go through here again real quick and let's see if they'll accept me in El Dorado. Now. I think they say my Digimon are cool looking enough. Hopefully. I would hope so. All of them are champions. And if they don't accept me, then screw them. Where did I do? Oh, you're not a member? Your Digimon aren't that cool looking either. You can't be a member. Why, man? Why? What are you doing to this to me for? Alright, I guess. Screw it. I'm gonna go over here then. So I can show you guys something else. Alright, let's try and play one of these guys real quick. Let's play some cards. Let's play this guy over here. The smartest tamer alive. Yeah, right. Let's card battle. This should be easy fun. Or something, I don't know. Alright, so let's Digimon card battle. He's got level 7. Alright, all our folders are exactly the same thing. Because they're standard folders, so you haven't played it yet. So I'm just doing this because I don't want to do this anymore. And I want to show you guys how to play it already. Alright, let's go to guess. Alright, a load phase is whenever you can use a program card. This is a program card. A program card is anything that is not a Digimon card. Alright, as you guys can see, those square right there, you can see underneath on the right corner, you see a square, and it has a zero on it. That means all these Digimons, the ones that cost zero, they're what do you call it? They are rookie Digimons. Rookie Digimons cost 0 points. Then, champions cost 1, ultimates cost 2, and megas cost 3. Now, as you can see, each one of them is a different color. This one is red, this one is blue, and this one is white. One thing is that for each one of them, for example, we got one white, so we get one white square. You see in the bottom right there? You see the squares? You got this white square, blue square, green square, red square, black square. Alright, white cards are white, blue are blue. Alright, so each one of them counts for 1 point. So we got one blue, we got one white, so we get 1 white point. We got 2 blues, so we get 2 blue points. We got no green, so we get 0 points. We got 3 reds, including this program card. It's a red card, as you guys can see. So we got 3 reds. We got no dark, we got no black monster, no black cards, so no black Digimon, so we get 0 points for black. And we got no brown cards. Brown cards always, always, always cost 0, no matter how strong they are. They always cost 0 points. So as you guys can see, this guy Gekkomon right here costs 1. So I got 2 points for having 2 blue cards. And then I can summon him for the cost of 1. So I still have 1 left because this one costs 0 to summon. So for example, if I didn't have any other blue and I only had the Gekkomon would pay for himself because he's 1 blue and he's a champion, so he pays for himself. But if the opponent were to use a card that takes away my 1 blue point, I wouldn't be able to summon him. So that's why it's important whenever you got high level 2 or 3 point ultimates or megas to have a lot of cards with that color. That way if they steal your points, you still have some to summon them. So yeah. So let's skip this program. No, use no program. Pass this phase. Now this is a phase where we summon them. As you guys can see, 0 points, 0 points, 0 points, 0 points, 1 point. As you guys can see, took away one of the blue points. Alright, now everything adds up. As you guys can see, the first point in each card is the attack points, and then the health points. The second is the health, the first point is the attack. If my attack hits his health, and if his health reaches 0, so my attack is 12, the enemy's HP is 7, his total is 7, so I would win. If he hits me with his attack of 5, I got 16 of health, so I would have 11 points left. Now, if for any chance we both end up at 0 health, then he wins. The computer always wins the tie. I believe that's the way it works. The computer always wins the tie. And if we both end up with, we still got health left, then the one with the highest health is the one who wins the match. And you gotta win 2 out of 3. So, do I wanna use a program card? Yes. I wanna use this card right here, which brings one of those to the field. Now, one thing I wanna say. If any cards that you don't use, they go back in your deck. Any card that you do use, goes to the recycle bin, so you can't use it the rest of the game. Alright, so you guys can see. We hit all his points, so he goes to 0. He hits us for 5. So we stay at 12. So I got 12 to 0, I win. So I win that one. Now let's do a little bit faster. Alright. As you guys can see right there, I got an ultimate. I'm gonna show you guys real quick. I'm gonna click no. See, we got no more blue cards, but since from the first duel, since we're still playing the match, you know, it's gotta be two, you gotta win 2 out of 3. The squares from that previous duel carry on. So I had used one blue square for the 2 I had, so now I only have 1. So then I got another blue card. Now I got another blue card, so that's onto that one. So I got 2 again. This is an ultimate, so it's gonna waste those 2 points summoning itself. And all these things, they're all rookies, so it don't matter. They all cost 0. As I said, the brown cards always cost 0. Alright, so. Alright, I'm gonna pass. I'm gonna say no because there's nothing else I can do. Nothing else I need to do to win. Alright, and that's how you win playing cards, and then you get a booster. Right, so I'm gonna show you about the boosters as well. But pretty much this whole video is just a big tutorial, guys. So if you know how to play the game, then no watches. Kind of too late, because if you got in this far watching it, then you're almost done. So I'm about to save and quit so I can go train. All right, so I'm gonna open up my booster. As you guys can see here, I got more Digimon's cards. Now the bad thing about brown cards, I want to say right now, put a brown Digimon from field to trash. There's a lot of cards that can beat brown Digimons. For example, this card is one of the very first ones you get, you know, one of the earliest ones you get. You use it, you kill it, and you kill a brown Digimon right away. So the opponent's got like a 50, a Digimon that's like 50 attack and 50 health. Just use this on and it kills it automatically. Puts it in the trash. That's the weakness of brown Digimons. They got a lot of things that are susceptible to them. And these are some of the stronger Digimons later on. You see right here? Brown, cost 0, 50-40. That's a weakness of Browns, though. But against random players that you'll encounter later on, Brown is pretty good. So let me go ahead and go heal myself with the kitty, and then go save the game, and that'll be it. And then I'm gonna go train in the training thingy, try to get 10 points on each one, at least 20. Yeah, 10 points on each one, get it all across the board, perfect. So I can be like at least 100 more points. Stronger with each in attack power. So when the next video comes up, my Digimons are gonna be like at least 100 points stronger. So what Patamon was like, what, like 40 attack, he's probably gonna be like 140, something like that. So let's go ahead and save the game. And Overlord Tico is going to be out. I'm gonna go eat. I'm gonna take a shower. No, I'm gonna go eat. I'm gonna cut the grass. I'm gonna take a shower. Is that it? Is that all I gotta do? Yeah, eat. Grass, shower. I believe that's what it is. Oh my god, so hopefully you guys have enjoyed this long 2 hours and a half, I believe. Something, let me check. Oh, how I've been playing for. It's gonna tell me right now. It's weird. It's a long time. Man, it's crazy. Alright, 2 hours and what? All right, 2 hours and 14 minutes. All right, guys, I'm out. Overlord Tico is out. Hopefully you enjoyed this first part. I don't know if I'm going to do this in days in a row, or if I'm going to do a lot of videos in a row in one day, but remember this. They're going to come. I'm not going to stop playing this game. It's one of my favorite games ever, so just keep in tune if you want to keep playing. If you want me to keep playing this, I probably try to upload at least one of these a day, one of these a week, so you're going to expect to see at least an hour of me playing this a week, so it don't matter. See ya. Peace. Maybe tomorrow, maybe later today, another one will pop up. But who knows? I don't know. Depends on my schedule. Depends on what I feel like playing. But it will come. See ya.